That is one big pile of shit.
The video that we are about to watch was actually suggested to me by a subscriber. So, let's see how it goes.
We're in Baalbek, Lebanon, 1 hour's drive from the Syrian border.
The man in this video is Brian Forster. He is a author, conspiracy theorist, and tour guide who has a honors Bachelor of Science in what I do not know, and spent his life making sculptures. So, I'm not going to put him on a very high pedestal of knowledge from the get-go.
Okay, we're now approaching the main quarry at Baalbek, and this is the one called the Stone of the Pregnant Woman.
At this point in the video, I'll do my usual spiel and remind you that down below in the description, I provide links for you to educate yourself on this topic, because what our buddy Brian here is going to say is not correct.
Now this is at least 1,200 tons, and recent excavations show that there are possibly larger ones underneath it.
Given measurements of the stone conducted in 1996 and an estimation of its general density, calculations have concluded that the stone weighs about 1,000 metric tons, or 1,100 short tons, US tons. And given his ambiguity in his descriptions, such as underneath and ton, I don't know if he's wrong or if he is just misinformed. It's hard to tell. And this is going to be a prevailing trend in this video and in, well, these sort of megalith conspiracies in general. The ambiguity by which he talks and discusses these topics makes it hard for me to disprove him because I don't know what he's talking about. And it also makes him sound more intelligent because you can't exactly point out the error, oh, this is where you got it wrong, because he never says anything substantial.
So here you get an idea of just the size of this thing is outrageous, and in relation to the temple for the other large ones, are resting right now. That is the Temple of Jupiter.
If you want to make an accurate size comparison of two different things, maybe you shouldn't zoom into a far distant object for that comparison. It's not exactly honest.
You're a big fat phony!
Like many megalithic sites on the planet, this has been misidentified as possibly being a work of the Romans.
Remember, Brian Forster is not an archaeologist. He is not a scientist. He was a sculptor, then he became an author, and now his job is being a tour guide. So take that into consideration with regards to literally everything he says. He's not a scientist, he's a tour guide.
Now the Romans built on top of the megalithic constructions at Baalbek, but there's no way they had the technology, tools, or probably even inclination to try to quarry the largest stone that would ever have been done in the Roman Empire here, somewhat in the middle of nowhere.
That last sentence was so chock full of misinformation and inaccuracy that we're gonna break it up into sections and tackle each one step by step.
Ain't nobody got time for that!
Now the Romans built on top of the megalithic constructions at Baalbek.
Building a city upon an ancient city is not a unique thing within archaeology. Baalbek is built upon Heliopolis, which is the name of this city in Greek and Roman times, and that city was built upon an ancient Egyptian or Assyrian city that we do not know the name of. This fact is interesting, but it is not unique.
But there's no way they have the technology, tools.
Notice he doesn't bring up what tools would have to be used to cut this limestone that the Romans did not have. Does he say the Romans didn't have hand tools? Because you can cut much harder rock like granite with just a chisel and a hammer. It would take a long time to cut a stone this big, yes, but limestone is not impossible to cut with hand stones. So what tools is he proposing they didn't have? Notice again, he's not saying. He's being ambiguous.
You're a big fat phony!
Or probably even inclination to try to quarry the largest stone that would ever have been done in the Roman Empire here, somewhat in the middle of nowhere in relation to Rome itself.
I'll address that last point first. Rome was an empire, not a city. You don't only build skyscrapers next to iron mines because that's where you get the steel. That is such a dumb argument. I hope you realize that before I had to address it. Now on to why they would want to quarry these very large rocks. I almost want to say that our buddy Brian here addressed this point already, but that would be a bit much, right? If within the span of a few minutes of his own video, he answered the question that he later brings up as evidence, like, that would just be too easy, right? If only there was this video clip of him pointing out why the ancient Romans would want to excavate these large stones for something. That would just be so, so wonderful.
So what we're looking at is a megalithic work predating the Romans, the Greeks, and the Egyptians by probably thousands of years.
I feel like a broken record here. Where is your evidence? I will give you even an example of something that would be good evidence. Ancient Roman, Greek, or even Egyptian or Assyrian manuscripts talking about these pre-carved out, pre-quarried out rocks upon arrival to the destination. But since we don't have that, we have no reason to assume these rocks were quarried before these civilizations arrived.
By an unknown civilization that clearly had some type of what we would call lost ancient high technology capability.
And I base that on absolutely nothing.
You do not need high technological capabilities to cut limestone. That is a relatively soft rock that is easily cut by hand tools. These people had hand tools. These people had the knowledge to make a square. How is this rock some magnificent evidence of advanced civilizations? That is bogus.
That just makes no fucking sense.
And you can see the tool marks and the grayness, so you see a lot of weathering on the surface.
What kind of tool marks do those look like, Brian? Please tell me.
And you see those interesting, almost crisscross cutting marks, as well as along the bottom of this block, there's a continuous line that goes around it, as if there was another kind of tool attempting to be used to separate this block from the bedrock itself.
I watched that clip about 8 or 9 times to try to figure out what line he's talking about, and I think I found it. The hilarious part about it is, like with earlier in the video, his own images show that this line that he is claiming some tool created is in fact not a line, it's just some natural cracks in the bedrock in the geology.
And we also have these test holes where they were testing for the integrity of the stone itself.
Just the slightest amount of Googling the topic will yield the idea that these stone holes are actually probably Lewis holes, a device used by the Romans which helped them lift and position masonry bricks.
Because this material is quite solid and holds together well, but on this wall, that's loosely compacted, almost junk, so you couldn't extract a large stone from this area. It would just crumble into pieces as it's doing here at the base.
When you quarry a stone, the whole point of going to that stone and digging it out is because you want that stone. Of course they didn't dig out the surrounding material, that conglomerate, it looks like, because that's not what they were going for.
I am shocked! Shocked! Well, not that shocked.